everybody. Welcome back to Jaqueline's Inside Out. We're so happy that you're here today and joining us for our episode 8, which is all about back to school. We hope that you're enjoying your summer, but back to school is coming soon, so we want to give you some tips and tricks on how to get back into the school rhythm. So we're here for you today, and stay tuned. Back, and we're here with Madison today. She's our model that came with us today to help us with back to school looks. So I wanted to just show you a couple different techniques for blending out eyeshadow. We're going to work on block shadowing, and I'm going to show you a couple things on blending out some of your skin as well, your skin tone. So if you have little spots that you are worried about and you want to tone them down, you just take a little red. This helps to neutralize the red. And you just take a little bit and dab that on, and that's gonna help to blend out any spots that you have. Teenagers get a lot of spots, get a lot of the acne, unfortunately, just from growing and your hormones and everything that's happening, stress and everything in your life. So you wanna just kind of tone them down and blot them out. So I just wanted to show you that we did do that. We prepped Madison's skin with that first, and then we're gonna go over and we're gonna do a little bit of powder over top. So you just take the powder and you go over your spots after you do your neutralizer. That was a neutralizing toning ability to put that on there. It tones the red down and takes some of that, out a little bit for you and blends it out. So then you just wanna go over with your powder and blend that out like that. So I just wanted to show you teenagers a little bit on how to do that so that you can, tone down any areas that concern you on your skin that you're worried about. So just, remember that little trick. Okay, so I wanna show you some block coloring with your eyeshadow. So I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna show you a little technique that you can do to get some block coloring in. So I'm gonna have you turn this way and just down just slightly. So I already prepped Madison with a little bit of a neutral tone on her eyelid and up here at the top. So I've already gave her a base. So what you wanna do is take a little bit of your color that you wanna use, whatever colors you're going with. I'm going with this little gray silvery color here. And we're just gonna block color. So you're gonna take it and you're gonna make like a little square on the end of it here. And you're just gonna square that out, and it makes a little block just by blotting it down. And you bring it over this way. And then you can take your another color and block color the inside as well. So you have two different tones going. And you're just blotting that on and making like a square. So you made two squares. You made a square on that side, a little block, and you made a block on this side of the silver. And then you can take a blending brush and you just blend them out together and blot it and blend them out. And that's gonna give you a little bit of a nice natural tone. It's gonna give you a darkness on the edge here, but it's gonna bring it all together and blend it out nicely. So it's just a way for teenagers to be able to do some colors and, just to get some little bit of tone in there and to bring out your eyes. Your eyes are so important because when people look at you, they're looking at your eyes and they're, they tell a story. So you want to brighten them up and bring them out. And block coloring will do that. I'm just taking the brush on one side to the other and then just putting our colors in there. You could do neutral colors, you could do, creams, mauves, whatever you want to do, but it's just a nice technique that you can do to share a little bit of a deeper look, like a smoky look to your eye. So whenever you're applying your your shadow, think of it as a block section and a block color. And then you can go through and then just lightly just blend it out. So there you have it. There's some block coloring on your eyeshadows to give you a little tip for the, you know, for the season for back to school. And I hope you enjoyed that technique. All right, so I want to go in and just show you a little bit about some technique on how to blend out your lips. A lot of times teenagers don't know exactly what to do there. So you want to just take a liner and just bring that from the top of your lip and out to the corner. And then the other side up and out to the corner. And then when you're working here, you can kind of do the same thing and just line it nicely. And it's always good to put a little prep work in before you actually go in with lip liner. So I prepped her lips and then we moisturized them a little bit. So if you put a little moisturizer or a chapstick or something on first and then line, it smooths out nicely, it glows better, and it, you know, it'll be easier for you to do it that way. So prep them a little bit first. And then you can take, after you line it, a little bit of your lip gloss and just smudge that out. And you want to do your liner first and prep your lips first and then put your gloss on over top. And I always like to go back after I have the gloss on, and then you can just reshape and define a little bit more with your liner. Okay, so I just wanted to show you that little tip for back to school on how to get your lips bright and fresh and looking pretty for back to school. Okay, welcome back. So I wanted to show you a technique using these sponge rollers. They're spiral rollers. They work really great for helping you to create some curls. So when the teenagers are off to college, off to school, and they really want to, you know, get some curl, but they don't have a lot of time, this is a great technique. So I went in, and you can hold on to that one, Madison. I went in and I rolled this up just to show you how I worked this. So you just take a little bit of the hair like this, a little section of the hair, and then you wrap this around the hair like so, and start to roll it up into a nice little curl, and then it locks in at your root. So then all you have to do to lock it in is you just pull these together and move them in together, and then you just let it hang. And that will create some wave, some curl. It will give you a little bit of hold, extra hold throughout the day. So you could go ahead and do these and set your hair for the evening or for school in the morning. You could sleep in these if you'd like. I'll take the other one. So again, you just pull the hair straight out. Take a nice section, maybe about an inch or so. You can spray it first. You can do this wet. So if your hair is wet, it will do a really nice curl pattern. But the other option you have is you can roll them, and then you can take the hair dryer and you can just apply some heat to them with your hair dryer. Now, obviously I didn't bring the hair dryer today, but you can do that. You can just hit it with the hair dryer, just turn the hair dryer on and keep going over top with the dryer. And that's gonna create some nice wave pattern, some nice curl. It's gonna give you a little bit of a soft look, which is really popular right now with the teenagers. So I just wanted to show you that little technique on how you can go ahead and do some nice little curls for back to school to help you in the morning to get out the door. You could sleep in these, like I said, or you can just do them real quick with a little bit of heat from your hair dryer. Okay, well, thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed that. So here's a little fun technique that you can do. The teenagers, the college students, they're all into different looks for their hair, but what's really fun right now is a half up, half down look. So I already preset Madison earlier, and then we used those curlers and we curled a little bit with the iron as well to give her a little wave here on the bottom, which is really, really nice. But I wanted to show you something that you could do up top here. So you could take a little bit of your section and you want to just grab a section here and section it off. It doesn't have to be perfect. Nobody has these perfect straight lines anymore. And you just want to pull this all up. And then you're going to go in and you're going to just put this into a ponytail right here. And if you could hand me my comb in there, Madison. And then you take your comb and you want to tease this area really good and get a lot of like lift and volume out of it. And then it gets to be a little bit wilder and messier. Okay, you can hold on to that. And then you take this part and you want to just sort of mess it, make it messy and come down and just tuck it around a little bit. And then can I have your tie on your arm there? Mm-hmm. And then you want to just take another band and go over top of this big messiness and just leave it there. The girls today are just all about a little messy look. Nothing perfect, nothing, you know, in like neat. It's just all about messy and smooth. And then you have the bottom part that you can leave down and just make that a little bit more smoother down here. But the girls today love like this little poof at the top, and you can take it and poof it down, pin it if you like. You can make it a little bit more secure if you like with some extra pins, extra hold, whatever you feel. And then you just take your spray and you spray over top of it. So this is a fun look for the teenagers, for college students that are going off to school that want something that's, you know, fun and creative and nice and trendy. And then you just spray your curls on the side. You can also just wear this straight on the side if you like as well. So it's a half up, half down look. And it just gives you that little bit of a fresh style, young, youthful look. You can make it as messy as you like, or you can make it a little bit more classy and sophisticated as well. But for today, we wanted to go with a little bit of the messy look. So that's all you need to do is just put it in there and then just spray it and lift it and tease it up. And that's it. A fun little look for back to school with your hair. Hey everybody, so welcome back to our fashion part of the segment. I wanted to bring you a little bit of fashions that are nice for the back to school look. Of course, scarves are going to be coming back into play now that the weather's starting to, you know, it'll start getting a little chilly here soon, hopefully not too soon. But you can roll this scarf around, you can make it into a nice soft look around your shoulders as well. It could be draped over like a scarf or just like a wrap you can do with it. It's really pretty for this time of year, and it's light, so it's not too heavy. And then also I wanted to show you our necklace that we brought along. It has like a little nice tassel to it. It's a silver round little gem, and then it has the tassel at the ends. The tassels are really, really popular right now. They're all the rage for the summer and going into fall. So that's a really nice look paired with that. And we brought along some new jeans that are in trend for the fall season right now, coming up for back to school. They are nice for this time of year because they still are comfortable and they're not as hot on your body. They're a little bit breathable. They have a little bit of stretch feel to them, which is really nice. They are, the anklets have a nice little roll-up section to them that come up a little bit and roll over top to give you that nice little look there. So it's a little stylish, a little bit trendy, and it goes really nice with these heels that we brought. They are a nice chunky heel, which is really comfortable. You can walk a little bit around better and easier in those. But I love the detail on the flowers and the roses that are on the shoe. It goes all the way around the heel, which is really pretty, in the back, on the front, in the toe. So it's really nice, and it has that pretty strap around the ankle, which is really, really pretty too. It defines your ankles a little bit more and gives them some shape, which is nice. So this is just our fall look for leading into fall, really. I mean, it's still warm out there, so you want to have a little bit of that coming back when you go back to school, but not too much. You still want to celebrate summer and keep the nice weather around as long as you can. So I just wanted to show you this little look for the day, and I hope you enjoyed this back to school look. Madison's doing a great job there. So I have another fashion part of the segment to show you today, and Madison is going to be modeling some wonderful fashions for us. So we have the necklace, again, is a nice drop necklace, and it's very pretty to have it dangling down. It has a little bit of the stones to it and the key type of look to it, which is really popular right now, a little bit of a chunky necklace. So that's just a really nice little extra accessory to help show your style. But I want to talk a little bit about her kimono, which is really pretty, the cover-up that she has on. It's a nice pattern with the flowers and the roses on it again. The roses are really popular right now, so it's really pretty for this time of year. And it has the little ruffle around the edges, which is really, really pretty. I love how the ruffle and the detail comes all the way up the top and then swings all the way back around to the bottom half of the kimono and back around, and then around the sleeves as well. It's really pretty. It's detailed. It's fun for this time of year, so it's really cute. And it goes really well with her jeans that she has on today. These jeans, again, are the ankle jeans, which are really, really pretty, and they're the gray tone, which is nice. You're going to be seeing a lot of that this season for fall. The gray tone is really popular. The lighter jean is nice for this time of year. And it also has a lot of the patchwork in it, which is really pretty. It has the holey sections that are detailed and open and frayed, which is nice to give you that little bit of a trend, a little bit of a style to it. And again, they're rolled up at the ankle, which is really nice. And then they also have some more detail into the ankle part that's frayed as well, which is kind of neat. That's kind of different looking. I haven't seen that yet, so that's really nice for the season. And then her little booty shoes are perfect too for this time of year. They're booty heels. They have a nice tie up to them, which is really, really cool. And then they have a zipper in the back. But I love the detail in them that they have. And the tie in the front is really cute too. So you can tie it up around your ankle. And then you have an open toe, so you can still show some of your pedicure for the season leading into fall. So these are cute little beauties that go really, really nice with her jeans that she has on, her ankle jeans that are really, really popular right now in the gray tone, which is nice for the season. And then it just goes really well with the kimono and the necklace, and it all pairs really good for back to school looks. They're comfortable and movable, just everything about it. So I also just wanted to highlight again her hairstyle, which is really cute that we worked on today. We gave her the little half up, half down look and the soft curls at the bottom with a little bit of the messy bun at the top. So it's really popular this time of year for everybody that, you know, for the young teens back to school. It's a nice, easy little look to do. And then her block coloring on her makeup for her eyes and her lips, just to help give you that little bit of natural glow and a little bit of shimmer for your daily routine. So I hope you've enjoyed everything that we brought you today for back to school. Thank you, Madison. You did such a great job here modeling for us today. We appreciate you coming in. So there you go. There you have it. Some looks for back to school, fall 2018. Okay, everybody, so welcome back to our next portion of our show today, back to school. I wanted to bring some essentials with me to talk to you a little bit about some different products that you could use to help in your daily routine. So I brought the clay mask. It's a French creamy pink clay mask. It works really well to detoxify your skin, to get the impurities out of your skin. It's great for teenagers to help with stress, anxiety, anything that's, you know, your skin is starting to feel the results of any of that. You start to have breakouts and acne. So this is a wonderful treatment that you can do once a week to help brighten, tone, and define your skin a little bit better. It's a pink clay mask, which helps to detoxify your skin. You just put it on, leave it on for a few minutes, and then just rub it off with some warm water, and it comes right off. So it's a great treatment. You should do that once a week, at least, especially during your school years. And also, I brought along It's a 10, which is a really nice leave-in conditioner that you spray into your hair. It helps with detangling, it helps with frizz, it helps to calm down your hair, it gives your split ends a little bit of nutrition and helps them to, you know, strengthen a little bit to mend the split ends. So it's a wonderful product. It's called It's a 10. You spray that in your hair, you comb it through, and it's really, really nice to help, you know, to help your hair throughout the day. And it helps with detangling the hair as well, like I said. So that's a great product to have on hand while you're away at school. Also, I have this root booster, which is wonderful here, and that brings a lot of texture, a lot of fullness, a lot of lift and volume into your hair. So if you struggle with body and you want to have a little bit of volume, you spray that at the root, and it's wonderful to give you that nice lift and volume to your hair. So it's a great treatment. These are just some nice essentials for you to have on hand when you go off to college, or if you're just going to, you know, if you're in high school and you want to have some nice products on hand, it's wonderful for that. So I hope you enjoyed this part of the segment of these products that I brought to help you with healthy hair, healthy skin, you know, just to get you on track for back to school. I wanted to bring to you our inspirational part of this show today for back to school. I want to give the students out there just a little bit of encouragement to always try and do your best. You know, we are always striving to do better. We're always striving to do good. Sometimes you have a hard day at school, or you're feeling the pressure. Just always remember to do your best and do what you can do. Get it done, but just, you know, try not to get too overwhelmed with it. Try to, you know, just have a good day and enjoy the time that you're there. So I brought along some little inspirational pieces for us to take a look at. You've Got This is a nice little reminder to look at that every day. If you find yourself a little notebook, a little something that gives you some kind of encouragement throughout your day, it's a wonderful way to start your day. So You Got This, don't worry about it. Just keep doing what you gotta do. You'll get through the school year, everything will work out great. And if you just do your best, like what's on here, and remind yourself every day that, you know, we all make mistakes, we all do things wrong, but just keep pushing through, keep working hard, and I'm sure you're gonna have a wonderful school year. So I wish all you students a great back to school year, and I hope that it all goes well for you and the parents out there, because I know how hard it can be to, you know, get your kids going with school and everything. So just wanted to give you that little inspiration and motivation to get you through your school year. Welcome back. I just want to recap what we went over today. We covered a lot of ground with back to school, which has been so fun. So I just want to recap what we went over just to give you a little extra, you know, so it's in your mind a little bit fresher. We talked about our scarves. We talked about accessories and how they are a great statement piece that you can do to just, you know, make yourself stand out a little bit more, show your personality, whatever you need to do there. So those are great tips for you. We also talked about our spiral rods, rulers that you can set your hair with. So you can take them. Again, there's two different ways you can do them. You can set your hair while it's wet and roll them up and let it dry. You can also set your hair with some setting spray and then hit that with the hair dryer. So that's going to give you some extra wave and curl too. If you're in a hurry and you just want to do something fun for the day or for the night, that's a great little tip. I showed you a little bit about how you can do some block coloring on your eyes with your eyeshadow and to blend that out, and also how you can use some of the lip gloss and lip liner to define your lips a little bit more. So keep those in mind, and make sure you moisturize your lips first prior to putting on your lip liner. It helps to glide that on a little bit better. Then we also talked about some of the skincare that is great for teens and, you know, just for college students to go ahead and use the mask once a week, which is really, really nice. We talked about our clay mask, which is great for impurities to detoxify your skin. We talked about some root lifter to help build volume and body in your hair. And we also talked about the It's a 10, which is really great to spray on and leave in your hair. It's a great leave-in treatment. You want to do that as well. So those are some of the products, essentials that you need for back to school. So I hope you enjoyed that part. And then we also talked about our inspiration, how you can do your best and how you got this. And just remember, as you're going through your school year, don't let it get you upset. Just keep moving forward. You know, do your best, try to do all you can do, everything will work out well for you. So I hope you enjoyed this. We also talked about some of our fashions that Madison had shown you with the scarves and the jeans and the heels. So just some inspiration for you to get through your day and, you know, to help you a little bit more with your back to school look. So I hope you enjoyed that. Thank you. So this was episode 8. I can't believe we've done 8 episodes already of Jaqueline's Inside Out. I'm so excited to be part of Bethel Park TV and the community here. It's such a wonderful, wonderful community to be a part of here. We do such a great job. I hope that you enjoy what we're bringing you. And you can visit us on YouTube at Dave Cable. He has a YouTube channel with all the Bethel Park TV shows. So you can find Jaqueline's Inside Out there. I'm Jackie from Jaqueline's Inside Out and Jaqueline's Salon, downtown Pittsburgh in the Grant Building. I hope you enjoyed what we brought you this this time for back to school. We'll see you next time. Until then, live your dreams.